Hello and welcome back to the Casual Gamer. Many of you have shown great interest in Nobara, so in this video I'll be sharing my experience with it. However, before I dive in, I want to address the sound issue that some of you have been experiencing when installing Nobara after the BIOS update. By the way, installations can be a lot easier when done on a big screen, so if you're looking for a dock, maybe the 6-in-1 docking station from Ivanki is for you.
Video games on the big screen and experience gaming in a whole new dimension. Experience silky smooth gaming on the big screen thanks to 30-watt turbo mode support for the ROG Ally. The dock also has ports so you can attach your peripherals. So what are you waiting for? Right now.
Now in all seriousness, the Ivanki 6-in-1 gaming dock is pretty solid. If you're in the market for a dock, you can use my affiliate link in the description and help out my tiny channel. When I created the guide, my ROG Ally was running on BIOS 3.23, which was the latest version at that time. In the past few weeks, two new BIOS updates were released, 3.30 and 3.31. Unfortunately, those who installed Nobara after updating to the latest BIOS have been encountering problems with both face button controls and audio. I personally tested this and can confirm that upgrading to 3.31 led to the loss of audio and face button controls. Updating Nobara didn't resolve the issue, at least not at the time I made this video. It appears that the Nobara Fixes custom kernel may address the audio problem, but I had issues when running the commands. As I mentioned in a previous video, I'm not a Linux expert and may be missing something here. So I found it simpler to roll back my BIOS from 3.31 to 3.23. You can find the links in the video description. To do this, simply download Winflash and the 3.23 BIOS from the Asus website. Install Winflash and extract the BIOS archive. Once it's installed, open File Explorer and locate Winflash. Copy the path and open Command Prompt. Type cd and paste the copied path. Then type Winflash space / no date. Winflash will open, select the extracted BIOS file, click update and then exit. Restart your Ally and it will boot into the BIOS and flash your device with the 3.23 BIOS. Proceed as usual and once done it will boot back into Windows. Now that we've tackled this, let me share my experience with Nobara and answer some of your questions. Why install Linux in the first place? Just open Task Manager and that should provide you with the answer. Windows consumes 40% or more of available resources up front. If you have a 32GB device, this might not be a big concern, but with 16GB shared memory, every resource counts. The more programs you have running in the background, the worse it gets. That is exactly why I recommend treating these devices as gaming machines only. If you intend to do more than browsing the internet, consider getting a laptop or desktop instead. At least those can be upgraded to some extent. I read a Reddit comment suggesting that those seeking a PC experience should use Windows, while those desiring a console experience should use SteamOS. Let me tell you that making these devices fully functional often requires more than just downloading a driver or installer and running it. While most distros like Chimera OS and Nobara offer a good out-of-the-box experience, as you've seen in my Nobara video, it can be challenging to get everything working. This is one of the major downsides. If you're not willing to spend time on GitHub or Discord and deal with command lines, Linux might not be for you. The out-of-the-box SteamOS experience on a Steam Deck is not here yet. At least not on the ROG Ally. Just getting the TDP controls to work can be a challenge, if you have no Linux knowledge. I personally attempted to install Nobara 3 times. I gave up twice when I couldn't get the face buttons to work. On the third attempt, I dedicated an entire weekend to gather information to make it work. Unfortunately, there are a few things that don't work on the Ally. At least not yet. For instance, putting the device into sleep mode messes up the buttons. It seems that Asus isn't very supportive when it comes to making things work on Linux. Hats off to the individuals that spend their valuable time reverse engineering the system to get Ally functionality in Linux to its current state. I have not tested gyro controls, but read that it's functional in some limited way. If you watched my last video, you saw that we can install a flat package for fan controls, which includes some other features. We also have a slider to set the charging limit, just like battery care on Windows. Someone in the comments mentioned that the fan profiles won't stick, but I tested the function with custom fan curves and can say that they're still functional after restarting the device. Just make sure you tap on apply. Maybe the mentioned issue was fixed in a recent update. But now to the question that's probably burning in everyone's mind. What about battery life and performance? Well, whether you use 20 watts in Windows or Linux doesn't make a difference. Energy consumption is the same, so expect similar results in the terms of battery life. Regarding game performance compared to Windows, Nobara offers a similar or near identical performance. Some games even run better on Nobara. For example, Lords of the Fallen looks completely flat on Windows, and there's no word on a fix. Another example is Metal Gear Revengeance, which won't even start on Windows 11. But then there are games that don't run on Nobara but run fine on Chimera OS, and most of the time this seems to be because the distros are using different versions of the Mesa drivers. But if you know how, you can always roll back your Mesa drivers to an earlier version. And that sums up my thoughts on Nobara. If you have an extra SSD lying around, go ahead and test drive it. But those who need to wipe their Windows installation, I understand that the lack of certain features can be a drawback. While it's said that Nobara and Chimera OS are close to resolving the sleep issue, it's uncertain how long it will take. Just know that I'm keeping an eye on both the Nobara and Chimera OS Discords, so I'll give you a heads up when the time comes. For now, I'm playing Lords of the Fallen on Chimera OS on my Aya Neo 2. Unfortunately, the Mesa driver version that comes with Nobara has a regression that causes Lords of the Fallen to crash in certain situations. I've been playing for more than 50 hours on my Aya Neo 2 without a single crash, although at a lower frame rate. However, the Neo 2 can achieve 30 to 50 frames per second at 900p. Having capped the device at 20 watts, I'm really enjoying the larger battery on the device. Anyway, that's enough about Nobara. Before I end this video, I want to express my gratitude to all my subscribers. I was floating at around 100 subs a month ago, and I'm happy to say that the channel has crossed 200. So, thank you for all your support. That wraps up today's video. If you enjoyed it, please like and subscribe. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. We'll be right back.